Hi, welcome to Open Up Academy, your go-to resource for growing your business. Today, we are going to talk about how you can incorporate your business. If you have just started your business, then you are definitely looking at incorporating it. But what does it mean? So let's keep aside the jargons for once, or for the legal professionals. What it essentially means is that you are separating your personal identity from that of your business. Or in other way to put it will be, you are giving your business a corporate and a legal entity. It also means that you, and if you have any partners, will now separate your personal assets from that of your business. Sounds interesting? Yes, because it has a huge tax benefit. We will cover the tax benefits in a separate video. You can check the description below for the link. For now, let's go about on how you can incorporate your business. So before we go into how you can incorporate your business, it's very important to understand the whys of it. Now the first reason, and as I had mentioned before, is that by incorporating your business, you can separate your personal assets from that of the business. But this also means that you are now separating your liabilities. So your business's liabilities, once incorporated, are solely your business liabilities and not your personal one. This one way is to protect your personal assets, correct? The second reason is that as a corporation, you can issue shares to your buyers. This is the exact reason why investors are more interested in giving capital money to a corporation and not an individual or a group of individuals. And the third more interesting point of why you should incorporate your business is that corporations, they are taxed only on profits. And these taxable profits, they can be reduced further by identifying them as qualified business expenses. Sounds interesting? It is. But more on that later. You can check out the link below in the description to learn more about how businesses are taxed. But for now, let's go into, or rather, let's dive deep into how businesses can get incorporated. Let's start with the basics on how you can incorporate your business. First, and this is a very obvious one, choose a proper business name. Sounds very simple, right? It's actually not. So while choosing a name, first of all, make sure that name is actually available for incorporation. Second, make it short and easy to pronounce. It sounds very superficial, yes, but you will be surprised to know that how many businesses falter at just this particular step. You might want to check out Companies Act 2013 to make sure that you are following all the guidelines here. You can also hire a lawyer to make sure again that the name that you have chosen for your business is the right one. Also, don't forget to check the domain name online. So once you set up your website under that registered name, it's available. So that's the first step that you should take while incorporating your business. So under the 1956 Companies Act, there are five types of business structures that you can register your company as. So the five are sole proprietorship, one-person company, partnership, limited liability company, and private limited company. Now let's go through all these structures one by one. You should also keep in mind that there are other business structures available, such as Hindu Undivided Family, HUF, the common acronym for it. But we will dive into that later. These five are the main ones, or the main business structures, that usually a small business owner or a startup founder like you go for. But let's go through them one by one. Let's start with sole proprietorship. What is it? It's fairly simple. As the name suggests, one person is the sole owner of the business, hence the name. And it is also the easiest to register as or to incorporate as. Why? Because there is no government regulatory paperwork involved. All you need to do is go to your chartered accountant, give your basic business details and your KYC details, and once she or he gives you a registration certificate, you are good to go. It is that simple. The second type of business structure is one-person company. What is it? As the name suggests, here is one person who has the sole ownership of the business. But how is it different from a sole proprietorship? The only difference here is that here you are identifying your business as a corporate, and thereby registering it or incorporating it, you are giving it a corporate identity. Now, this sounds good, right? Because when it comes to taxation, this immensely will give you a benefit. But since this is also a corporate identity, the registration for it or the incorporation for it is not that simple. You still need to talk to your chartered accountant for this, but here you will need to submit documents which are as per the Memorandum of Association or MOA. Talk to your CA, and for a nominal fee, they will provide you the necessary details for it. So the third business structure is partnership, and this is very popular, specifically if you are just starting out a new business with, let's say, your co-founders or business partners. Why? Because to incorporate this as a business, this business structure as your business, all you need is a partnership deed, which is essentially an agreement between you and your partners. And this agreement chalks out all the duties and obligations that you and your partners have mutually agreed upon. It also talks about the profit sharing details. Now, keep in mind, while talking to your CA, it's very important to highlight, or rather specifically agree upon, what are the profit margin shares going to be like. Talk to your CA, talk to your business partners, and only then finalize. So out of all the business structures that we are talking about today, limited liability is the most flexible business structure available out there. It actually takes all the better parts of other structures available, which means less paperwork, safety from liabilities. It also gives you a sort of protect net or a safety net in terms of tax liability and profit sharing, which is why this particular business structure is gaining popularity among new business owners and startup founders. A private limited company, or LTD, is the fifth business structure that we are going to talk about today. Now, a private limited company can have from anywhere between 2 to 200 partners or business owners, right? Now, when it comes to the company's debt, the amount of debt is subjected to how much that partner, that particular business partner, has his or her shares in that company. A limited, private limited company can also issue debentures and raise funds from the public. That's why once the business is growing, it's ideally recommended that you incorporate your business as a private limited company. And this is the most interesting part. As a private limited company, you will also enjoy more tax benefits out of any other business structure. So this was all more or less the five more important business structures that are available to you to incorporate your business. What I would recommend is that you read up on them more in detail. You can also take a look at our more detailed guide. The link is in the description below, and choose what is more suitable for your particular business.
How to get a certificate of incorporation in India. Checklist of documents needed. DSC, Digital Signature Certificate. Form 1 for incorporation of company in India. Form 32 for particulars of managers, secretary and proposed directors. Director identification number of all proposed company directors. Original copy of the formal letter which is published by ROC about company name availability. Form 18 for address or situation of the proposed company. Formalities to be followed. Obtain a TAN card, documents obeying Act of Shop and Establishment if required. Registration document of STPI, Software Technologies Box of India, if required. Both foreign and Indian directors need to have authorized agencies' digital signature certificates. Obtain a PAN, that is permanent account number, from the Income Tax Department of India registration documents of IEC Import Export Code from Foreign Trade Director General for International Trade if required. RBI approval for investing in FIPB and India support of foreign companies if required.
So that sort of sums up about our video on how you can go about incorporating your business. If you have any further doubts, let us know in the comment section below and we will address it. And please keep following us for more such informative videos on how you can grow your business. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you soon.